Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Mount Horeb.
Good morning.
We'd like to thank our singers and everything and our deacons for our wonderful worship for the Children's Day. What I'm going to do is I'm going to read from Psalms 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh, my enemies and foes, they stumbled and fell. Though an army may encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war may rise against me, on this I will be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret place of his tabernacle. He shall hide me. He shall set me high up on a rock. I've read to you Psalms 27, verses 1 through 5. We have a moment of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, bless the kids today, for they have brought, bring forth the legacy and the word that come forth from thee. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for those that could not make it today, that those that made it, that we're here to serve you in truth and peace. May you give us prosperity, Lord, for the prosperity comes from not a worldly gain, but from the spiritual wealth that comes forth from thy word and your loving son, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for everything and all everybody in the house say amen.
Good morning, Mount Horeb. Good morning, Facebook. Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. We just want to welcome everyone here in the household of faith. We thank you for coming on today. You can worship, bless God any kind of way you want to. Just sit back, relax, and again, you are welcome, welcome, welcome.
We have any other worshipers? Give me a little bit more volume up there. Check one, two. A little bit more, Trayvon. I can't hear. Come on up and stand up and let's usher God into here. Come on, I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. Now I'm singing. Jesus lifted me. One more time, I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. Come on, are you glad this morning? Jesus lifted me when I was. Jesus lifted me, singing glory. I'm so glad Jesus Now I'm singing, Lord, Jesus lifted me. Satan had me bound, but Jesus, come on, put a smile on your face. Satan had me bound, but Jesus, Satan had me bound, but Jesus. Now I'm singing, Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad. I'm so glad Jesus is. I'm so glad Jesus is. Singing glory, glory, hallelujah, glory, Jesus lifted me. You can be seated. Give God a hand praise as you take your seat.
Thank you.
Will you help me just open up your mouth and glorify God? If he's done anything for you.
From God tonight. Listening to me on this record, I don't know what it is you're going through, but God said you can get your breakthrough tonight. Look at somebody, say, I'm gonna get my breakthrough tonight. Right now. Turn around behind you, say, I'm gonna get an instantaneous breakthrough. Now you've been praying and seeking God and fasting, but when you ask God, do you really have faith that he can do it? Do you serve a God that is able? Do you serve a God that is strong and mighty? Well, if you do, can I tell you how to get your breakthrough? Say, Kirk Carr, how can I get my breakthrough right now? You don't know what I'm going through. You don't know what I've been through. This is how you can get it tonight.
Hallelujah. Let the church say amen. Come on, come on. Let's give it up for our young folk. Hallelujah. When praises go up, blessings come down. Hallelujah. Let us prepare for our offertorial worship. Now is a time that we all can participate in worship by way of our free will offering and our tithes and gifts. Being reminded of what Moses said in the 23rd chapter of Numbers, verse number 19. Moses said that God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. Had he said it, and has not done it? Has he promised and has not fulfilled? You can trust the Lord with everything that you have. Let us pray. We're going to ask one of our ministers to come up and pray over the offering. God bless you.
Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much, God, that we have something to share this morning. God, we can remember those times when we came in your house and we didn't have absolutely nothing. Oh, but God, we're giving this morning as a testament of how far you brought us. And God, we know you will never let us run out of what we intend to share. So God, with this money, it's a testament of our love. We share love today, oh God. We share peace and we pray in the name of share peace and we pray of Jesus, God, that you'll give back to your people that are giving today. We love you and we honor you with our gifts. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray, amen, and thank God. God bless.
Amen. If this is your first time worshiping with us, Mount Horeb is a unique church. We only have one offertorial period, and if you want to give, now is the time. There are three ways that you can give, and they are posted up on the screen. Thank you. Amen. Thank you.
Christ. I just stand here this morning to say thank you. Yeah. I don't know if it's just me. It could be me. I don't know about you, but some days I wake up and I think, how I'm going to do this and how I'm going to do that. But then I remember that as long as I have faith the size of a mustard seed, yeah. I don't need nothing else. Yeah. So what I want y'all to do for me today is just not look at me, but look through me till you see Jesus and know that all we have to do is stand and he'll step right in.
CD. Just dance, and then you
care of. After you've gone through the hurdle, after you've gone through the pain, oh my, after you've gone through the storms, hallelujah, hey, after you've gone through the rain.
Do better. Testing. Okay, there we go. Hey, amen. We can do better than that. Let's give our youth one more hand of praise. First, give an honor to God. To our pastor in his absence, it's just an honor to be in the house one more time. Amen. Especially on this Youth Sunday, as I stand before you, I always say we're not just the streetwalkers and the TikTokers and the Instagrammers and the tweeters, but we know God too, and it's just an honor to stand before the people of God and show that we have a relationship with God as well. Because these kids, they can be anywhere right now. They can be doing their own thing. They can still be at home watching TV. We got some young adults in the choir stand. They could be at brunch right now. So it's just, somebody hear me, like, it's just a blessing to see young people in the church giving God the glory. And now, not only can we sing and dance and read scripture, but it's preaching time. Amen. It's preaching time. And this evening, well, excuse me, this afternoon, we have a young man that is coming, another young minister that has grown up in the church. He has been singing, playing drums, and now he's preaching. So it's an honor for me to stand here and present this young man, as he is he's definitely an old soul in a young man's body. He is definitely an old soul in a young man's body. I'll never forget his first sermon. He took it to Calvary, and he hooped a little bit. And I told him ever since then, I say, man, next time you preach, you better behave yourself. Papa gonna sit you down. But without further ado, we all standing to our feet as we get ready to receive the minister of the hour. We are all elevating our right hands and just repeat after me and say, Reverend Robert Mason, preach the word, as we receive the Reverend Robert Mason.
Amen. Amen. Song says, I couldn't seem to fall asleep. There was so much on my mind, searching for that peace. But the peace I could not find. So then I kneeled down to pray. Pray, help me please. Then he said, you don't have to cry. So I'll supply all your needs. Soon as I stop worrying. Worrying how the story ends. When I let go and I let God have his way, that's when things things start happening. When I start looking back at them, when I let go and I let God, let God have His way. There's so much going on. Sometimes I can't find my way. And oftentimes I struggle from day to day. I had to realize that it's not my battle. It's not my battle to fight. I have to know if I put it in your hands, that everything will be alright. Soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, when I let go and I let God have His way, that's when things start happening. When I stop looking at back then, when I let go and I let God, come on, sing it with me. Let go, and let God. My brother, you can't do it on your own. Just let God. My sister, you can't handle let it. So let God. Soon as it stops worrying, then and only then will I. When I will let go, that's when things start happening. I let go. Then I let go. Then I let God. Let God have His way. Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for letting us wake up in our sound mind, the activity of our limbs and the ability of our senses. Father God, we know that today was not promised and neither is tomorrow. But we are glad to see today and hopeful for tomorrow as well. Father God, we know that we may not be who you want us to be just yet. But we know that with you, we can be all that you need us to be in the near future. Father God, bless me so that you may give a word to your people, that the word may touch people, deliver people, and set people free. Father God, give a word to your people, oh God. May it bless hearts and clear minds and make it sentimental into their everyday lives, oh God. Oh God, just heal today, deliver today, set free today, oh God. Oh God, we know you can do it because we know who you are. God, we know who you are, and we just want to say thank you for being who you are for us. Father God, we know we haven't done right, but we come here today thanking you for just giving us mercy. Father God, we just want to say thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Would you please grab your Bibles and head to Jude chapter 1, please. Jude chapter 1, verses 17. When you have it, say, I have it. Are we all there? But beloved, remember ye the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own ungodly lusts. These be they who separate themselves, sensual, having not the Spirit. But ye, beloved, building up yourselves in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. And of some have compassion, making a difference. Last verse. And others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating even the garment spotted by the flesh. And that was John, that was Jude 1, 17 through 23. And what I want to use for a subject for today is what to do when there's nothing left. Shall I repeat it again? What to do when there's nothing left? What we want to focus on is verse number 20. But ye beloved, building up yourselves in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. I want to begin by saying that sometimes when we find ourselves in a tight situation, we want to call on someone for help. Some don't understand what I'm trying to say. Let me give you an example. When the police pulls you over and arrests you and drives you to county, the first thing we want is a lawyer. Next thing we want is a phone call. And when we make that phone call, it's either to your mom or to your dad or to whoever raised you growing up. What I'm trying to get at is that we need to stop depending on folks who may not be there for us and depend on a person who will always be there to help no matter what situation you are going through. You may be asking, Brother Preacher, what are you trying to say? What I'm trying to say is we need to stop asking people on this earthly plane for help when there's a man who is omnipresent who can help you with everything you have need of. You may ask again, what are you trying to say, Brother? What I'm trying to say is God will be there for you. He is always there when you need him the most and when you think you need him the least. God is there for you through your bad times and through your good times. He's there for you, and y'all not listening to me today, but he is there. God is there through your trials and tribulations. God is there when your friends aren't there. God is also there when your boyfriend or girlfriend stands you up. God is there when the person you thought left you hanging there to dry. God will be there. I'm getting a little riled up. I gotta hold on a little minute. Let me share something with you. Stop putting your faith in people that can't help you as good as God can. That reminds me of the story of Abraham. It's one of my favorite stories. When God spoke to Abraham and told him to sacrifice his only son Isaac on the mountain Moriah, when brother Abraham heard the command, he did not hesitate. He put all of his faith in God, not just some of it, not 1%, not 20%, not even 70%, but 100% faith into God, not even questioning God why I should do such a thing. But as confused as he was and as hurt as he was, he did not bit to question or hesitate God. He sacrificed his only son, Isaac. So what I'm mainly trying to say is that we need to stop putting our faith in people, but we need to obey the will of God. Another thing we have to stop doing is being gullible and letting people walk over us. Yes, being gullible can be a good thing at times, but for the most part, it is not good for you. What I realize in certain people, as soon as we find that person, we like to tend to grow a soft spot for them almost instantaneously. But my brother, that's where the problem starts. And you may ask, what do you mean, brother? And what I'm trying to say is the problem is that when we grow soft, we should get more information on the person before we grow soft. Reason being, once they hurt you and bring you down, it seems as if we cannot get back up. All because we let our feelings get the best of us. Now, I'm not saying we should just not like someone. I'm saying that you should never like someone in due, you should like someone in due time. Don't rush something that's may never gonna happen. Don't rush something that is not meant for you to happen. Backtracking to my first sermon, don't rush your season. God knows the gift and when to give it. He knows our wants and he knows our needs. And sometimes a relationship isn't what we need, it's what we want. How you gonna tell someone who's in a relationship when you're not in one how you gonna tell someone how to be in a relationship when you're not in one or haven't been in one before? That's like a mother telling someone how to be a father, or a member of the church telling a pastor how to preach or how to pray. We just can't do it all. Sometimes we have to experience it and give it to someone else. Have I got a witness? How are you going to tell me how I can preach or how I can worship my God when you barely know who God is and what he can do for you? How are you going to tell me how to pray when you've never had a prayer and gotten on your knees, head bowed and body bent, asking God for forgiveness? How are you going to tell me? Because if you don't know God for yourself, I don't want to hear it. Let me go back into the word. I was saying God is always there for you. You may be like, you may be asking, how do you know he's be there for you? Well, was he there when your parents left you when you went off to college? Yes. No one but God was there when your friends left you hanging there alone at the lunch table, wanting to be with the cool kids. No one but God was there when you were struggling in college when you were alone. Your parents were not there for you right then and there because they were somewhere else that you could not be with them. Who was there? Nobody but God. Your parents wasn't there all the time, but the time that there wasn't God, but the time that that wasn't there, God was there. Let me ask a question. Who was there when you graduated from high school and went on to college? Who was there protecting you when you was home alone, scared, rocking in your boots? Who was there when your friends abandoned you and left you standing there in the middle of the road? Who was there to pick you up when you fell? Well, let me tell you who was there. The one who was there was born in a manger. The one who healed all diseases. The one who didn't write any books, but later in his name was many books. The one that death couldn't catch, tomb couldn't hold, sinners can't break, the warring sea couldn't stand, and the rose of Sharon. He is the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He is my motherless when he is my mother when I am motherless, my father when I am fatherless, my friend when I am friendless. He is my rock in a weary lane, my shelter in a time of storm. He is the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, the Lord mighty in battle. He is the one that picks me up when I'm down. He is my healer. He is my deliverer. He is my redeemer, my peacekeeper. He is creator of the world. He is the Lord of history. He is, always was, always is, and always will be. He is the one who can help you withstand anything that comes in your way. Have I got a witness? Come on now. He is the one who woke you up this morning and closed you in your right mind. He is the one who allowed you to drive safely in your vehicle to this holy sacred place. He is unchanged, undefeated, unmoved, undismayed. He is Adam's redeemer, Noah's ark, Moses' bush on fire. He is bread when you're hungry, water when you're thirsty. He is Luke's great physician, God's word made flesh. He is the lily of the valley, the bright and the morning star. He is distinctive in supernatural capacity, exclusive in spiritual beauty. Ooh, he is the God of God, the host of hosts, the prince of all princes. Anybody here who knows about my God, if the Lord has made a way for you, you ought to be able to clap your hands and give God all of the praise. If the Lord has made a way for you, if the Lord has made a way for you, you ought to be able to clap your hands. If the Lord brought you out of a situation that you did not know how to get out of, get out of your seat and give God all your best praise. If the Lord has opened doors and windows that were shut on your face, you should be able to lift your hands and give God all the glory. If the Lord gave you a roof over your head, food on your table, and shoes on your feet, clothes on your back, you ought to be able to shout his name. If the Lord gave you a tongue to taste, hands to feel, nose to smell, feet to walk, eyes to see, ears to hear, you ought to be able to give God your best praise, because I don't know anybody else who can treat me better than my God can. You ought to be able to say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my job. Thank you for my calling. Thank you for my pastor. Thank you for what you did on Calvary. You may ask, well, what did he do on Calvary? Well, I'm glad you asked. Let me give you a breakdown of what happened on that blessed day. He brought Jesus to a hill called Calvary, where they nailed his hands and ribbed his feet. They put a crown of 72 thorns on his head. But there was one mistake that they made when they was doing all this to my Jesus. There was one mistake, and that mistake was lifting him high. Because Jesus said, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men. Not one man, but all men unto me. They lifted him high, and then he died. They laid him in a burial tomb. He stayed there all night Friday night, all night Saturday night. But when the time was right, early Sunday morning, he got up out of the grave where he rose. Then he rose, and he rose up with all power, both in heaven and in earth. So I come before you today, put your faith in Almighty God, because when you're down, he'll pick you up. When it seems that all the run wells run dry, when it seems you haven't give up, when it seems you have nothing left better to do, when it seems that all help has run dry, but keep your faith in him and he will direct you. Because God is a God who is able to keep, the Lord is able to keep me from falling. So what I want to encourage you, I want to encourage you to lift up your head and put your faith in God. And trust me, he will not let you down. Because when I tried God, look at where I am. When I tried God for the first time, I said, God, why would you want someone like me? I've done bad. I've done all I can do. But God said, I want you. I want, like Reverend Smith said, I don't want you like how you are. I want you like how I can make you. He molded me. He can mold you. And he can create you to be the man or woman he wants you to be. So what I'm trying to tell you today is put your faith in God. Because when there's nothing left to do, all you can do is just give God the praise. Give God the honor. Give God the glory. Because my God is a God who can heal all. Ooh, he heals you when you're wounded. He makes you stronger when you're weak. He brings everything to you. He was able to keep you from falling that one day on Calvary. What to do when there's nothing left? Thank you. Just trust in God. Know everything will be all right. Without God, we don't know where we would be today. Without God, I don't know who or where I would be. If you know you've got God, imagine how life would be when you didn't meet God. Would have been dead, rocking in my grave. But God. Nobody but God can change you. Nobody but God can heal you. Nobody but God can deliver you. Nobody but God can set you free. Nobody but God can bring you out of a sick bed. Nobody but God can bring you out of a mental hospital. Nobody but God can bring you out of a closed situation. Nobody but God can bring you out of an abusive situation. Nobody but God can bring you out of financial issues. Nobody but God can bring you out of prison. Nobody but God can bring you out of poverty. So what I want to say with you today is, what to do when there's nothing left? Look to God, because He knows all the answers. Thank you.
What to do when there's nothing left? I don't believe in coincidences when it comes to church, but isn't it something that Jakara just stood here and danced to a song saying, when you've done all you can, just stand and wait on the Lord and put your trust in Him. And then Robert gets up here and preaches what to do when there's nothing left. So let that be a message to somebody. When you found yourself stuck between a rock and a hard place, when you find yourself in a deserted place, look to Jesus. Look to God. Because the scripture says, now unto Him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless. What a word from such a young minister. Let's give him another hand and continue to encourage Reverend Mason to keep preaching the word. Don't be discouraged by people and things that don't go right, things that don't go our way. Keep looking to God and keep staying in His word. What an awesome word that applies to all of us. The doors of the church are now open. After hearing such a mighty word, we can't go on with the program without extending the call to discipleship, whether it be candidate or baptism. You may just have a testimony. You may need prayer. This is a grand opportunity. As we extend the call and open the doors of church, there may be one. We won't force you to come. All we can do is extend the privilege. The doors are always open. The opportunity is yours. It's up to you to seize the moment or let it pass you by. Amen. It's ours to extend. It's yours to accept or to reject. The results are in the hands of Almighty God. One more time, let's encourage you.